Welcome to the Storm Watch 9 webcast with a storm update for you on Tuesday afternoon. Here are your storm headlines, and the main focus of the storm system is going to be a heavy wet snow for the northern half of the state, although there could be some mixing with sleet at times tomorrow afternoon. The main push for southern areas is going to be several hours of sleet along with some rainfall mixing in with those snowflakes, and I think everyone ends as some snowfall. The main timeline for this system, it does look like we'll start to see some snow push in to western areas of the state as quickly as 7 or 8 o'clock tomorrow morning, and that will start to navigate northward into the north country, and we're expecting 2 to 5 inches of accumulation by the time we get toward the evening commute tomorrow. For southern areas, I think it is warm enough that anything we do see will be either in sleet or rain form through a good part of tomorrow, even though you may start as some snowflakes. And from there, once we get beyond daylight, that's when we'll start to see a changeover in central and southern areas of the state, especially just before midnight in southern areas. And that snowfall could be heavy at times after several hours of rain and sleet during the daylight hours tomorrow. So on the satellite picture, some breaks in the overcast, temperatures approaching or besting 50 in a couple of southern spots this afternoon, 40s elsewhere. And there's the disturbance back to our west, which right now doesn't look like all that much, but eventually will continue to gradually develop as we work our way through time. You will notice here on Futurecast, and this paints the picture pretty well for our forecast thoughts. Usually this is just one of 8 or 9 maps that we are looking at, but this one pretty much can tell the tale of our thoughts at this point. You'll notice that we do have partial sunshine this afternoon, and even starting the evening with clear skies, lows will be able to drop back into the 20s tonight. So as I mentioned, maybe as early as 7 or 8 o'clock tomorrow morning, we may start to see some snowflakes develop in parts of the state, but we're not really expecting any accumulation before 10 a.m. You notice that area of snow continues to shift northward, and there is your 2 to 5 inches of accumulation just before we get in toward the evening commute. While southern areas, anything we do see at this point during the afternoon will be a mixture of some sleet or some rain, and again, some snowflakes, but really not anything in the way of accumulation. I think that holds off till later on in the evening. The heavier thump of precipitation really starts to develop after 2 or 3 o'clock tomorrow afternoon and will extend itself to right around daybreak on Thursday. You can see it is all snow up north. Snowfall rates could be 1 to 2 inches per hour at times, and that could be a heavy, wet snow. Won't have the wind quite yet during the evening, but again, sleet and rain the farther south and east you go across the state. But everyone changes over to snow as the colder air eventually rushes in. And so you can see that the least amount of time with the accumulation amounts will be in southeastern areas of the state. The farther you go west, the farther you go north, the more chance and the more hours that you're actually going to be snow out of this system. And so that's where the amounts eventually get heavier. And the system should wind down by mid-morning on Friday, maybe up north by late morning. And the additional accumulation once we get beyond the morning commute should be almost nothing at this point. Now, the accumulation map has not changed. Our forecast thoughts for Manchester to the shoreline is mainly during the daylight hours, little if any accumulation, and most of what we get will be on the backside of this system. But again, the farther north and west you go away from Manchester and Concord, that is where we start to get in elevation and farther away from the coastline, and temperatures just that couple of degrees colder, which certainly is going to set up the chance for 3 to 6 inches of accumulation and several extended hours of that snowfall. Now, you get from the upper valley and north of the lakes region northward. That is where we are expecting the heaviest of the snow. It will be a heavy, wet snow. And that 6 to 12 plus, that plus has been indicating that as long as these maps really lock in on the exact track of the storm, which it looks like now they are having a tendency to do, that we could be looking at several areas with over 15 or 16 inches of snow out of this system. And normally the normal shadowed areas north of the White Mountains won't be with as far northern track as the system continues to work its way gradually over Massachusetts in the closest scenario for us. So sunshine and high clouds this afternoon, 40s to lower 50s, and then we drop into the 20s to lower 30s tonight. Precipitation gradually moves in tomorrow, heavier especially for southern areas after 2 or 3 o'clock, but by then we'll already have 2 to 4 inches of accumulation up north. Everyone changes over to snow just after midnight, Wednesday night and into Thursday morning, and the last several hours of this will be snow, which will make things awfully slick, and I think the toughest of the commutes will be Thursday morning with gusty winds to go along with it.